There are some cracks within NATO over what it is doing and not doing in Libya. And as the talking goes on in Europe, the fighting continues in the North African country. Joining me now is Prince Idris Al-Senussi, a member of the Libyan royal family, which fled the country when Muammar Gaddafi assumed power in 1969. Prince Idris has been involved with the opposition movement for decades. Prince Idris, thank you very much for being here.
Thank you for inviting me.
I know you were in contact with people on the ground constantly. What can you tell us about the latest communications you've had and what you're hearing?
Well, I was in contact from yesterday and today with people on the ground through Skype. The problem they have is the lack of medical supply, lack of first aid equipment, lack of fuel, and of course the military side, they have lack of ammunition, training, and all. This is what they really lack to defend themselves.
Is there a sense that they're losing ground to Gaddafi forces?
No, the morale is very high, but they would like to see more engagement from NATO, and they would like also to see more engagement from the United States, really, because they all look up at the United States as the real power behind NATO. And they would like to see more engagement, more involvement of the United States, so they can feel more comfortable and more protected.
You know that there's a concern here in the U.S. about who the opposition really is, about what makes up this rebel group. What's your assessment of the opposition, the whole group?
This is an opposition of people who are moderate. They are not al-Qaeda. They are not Islamist combatants, like they say here. They are really people who seeks democracy, seeks their basic rights, which is freedom, and they believe in free elections, free democracy, free representation. That's what they believe. So there is no elements of al-Qaeda or any kinds of other Islamist movement. As you know, the Senussi movement in Libya is a moderate movement. And it's a Sufi movement, and al-Qaeda is a Wahhabi movement. They will never accept a movement called the Senussi movement. So this is the people in Libya, they're basically mostly belong to the Senussi movement.
But Libya largely is a tribal nation. It has been for decades. If Gaddafi is exiled, leaves, or is killed, what is next?
Next is going to be free elections. The people of Libya will be united under one flag, one constitution, which was there. As you know, the constitution was suspended, was never abolished. So the people were united under the constitution in the past, and they will be united under this constitution with some modifications to it, where there's the part of the monarch to be taken out, and people will elect a head of state who can be a president or whatever they want to call him, and they will have a representation. They'll be united all under one flag, under one constitution. So there's no risk for a dismantling of the state of Libya.
You know, there's some skepticism about that, about the possibility that something could materialize like that, looking at how the rebels fight and how they're semi-disorganized on the ground currently.
Unfortunately, these people who have started the fighting mostly were students or young people who were seeking only democracy, and they were not prepared to go for a fight, to be a military fight. And Gaddafi has pushed them. They had to defend themselves. That's the reason they took up the arms, and they were not trained. But now they're getting training, and they lack people to come and train them. But once they be trained, they will be very well organized and disciplined.
So if Gaddafi remains in power, that's unacceptable.
It's impossible. It's not unacceptable. It's impossible.
Or Gaddafi, any of his sons.
It's not acceptable. Anything that will include Gaddafi remaining in power or his sons will not be acceptable by the Libyan people.
I have 30 seconds here. If you have a message to leadership in NATO or the U.S., what is it?
Please step up your military operations. Please, the United States, we ask you not to ever, but to take leadership and help us get rid of Gaddafi. We are not asking you to put boots on the ground, but we are asking you to give us training, give us arms, give us military air support.
Prince Idris, thank you very much for your time.
Thank you.